Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, we continue to explore flattening operators in RxJS library. And in the previous video, we had a look already at two of them. We had a look at merge map and switch map. And by the way, the link to this video will be up there. And today, we will learn what the difference between ExhaustMap and concatMap. My name is Dmitry Mozhensky, you are watching Decoded Frontend channel, and let's get started. Well, let's get started from the mental model we used in the previous video. First, we have a Durum Chef stream, which emits over time different Durums for some particular order and then completes. There are many Durums might be emitted during this stream, but for simplicity, let's imagine that this stream emits only one Durum and then it completes. Then imagine that we are going to buy some Durum. So we go to the kiosk, which is in this case works as a concat map. And here happens a function where the argument is my money or my order, and this function returns me a process of Durum creation because it cannot be done immediately, right? So it takes some time to cook it. So I kind of subscribe to this stream and wait when chef delivers me the Durum I ordered. And as I mentioned in the previous video, all flattening operators like switch map, merge map, exhaust, and concat map, they all handle differently concurrency, or the cases when new order arrives but the previous one is still in progress. In case of concat map, all subsequent orders are queued, basically like in real life. And once the first order is done and Chef Durum stream is completed, then concatMap creates a new stream for the next customer, and this process just repeats. For ExhaustMap, the behavior is obviously slightly different. For the first customer, everything is pretty much the same as for concatMap. But when arrives the second customer, he or she isn't queued, but ignored. So ExhaustMap ignores all subsequent orders until it has some active stream inside. And only when this stream is completed, only then ExhaustMap can receive orders further. But this order will be done for the third customer because the second one was ignored. Imagine that they close the kiosk while they making durums and ignore all other orders until they finish the current one, which would be kind of stupid in real life, but doesn't matter. All right, guys, let's have a look how everything looks in the code, and let me quickly onboard you into this application I prepared for this video. So, very simple app consists from app component. Inside the view we have three buttons, and every time we click on any of this button inside the order stream, we emit some object which has some unique ID. You know, it's just, you know, in order to differentiate all those orders. And here below we have already the subject and this order stream, and we remember that in RxJS subject it is observable and observer at the same time, so we can cast some value into the stream using next method. And already here below inside ngOnInit I create a stream from my order. There I use tab operator just to console log which order has been arrived, yeah, in order to better understand what's going on inside my stream. Then I have switch map. Currently we'll replace it in this video, and inside the switch map I actually call makeDurum method from my Durum service, which I injected inside the constructor, right? And this makeDurum service just takes the parameter user ID, which is probably better to replace with the order ID. but doesn't really matter. And under the hood, makes a request to the server using HTTP client library from Angular. So here we will get an observable, and inside the stream will be emitted the value which returns server to us, and then this value will be casted down to the subscriber and it will be console logged. Yeah, so that's basically explanation how our data flows. And let's have a look how it looks in the browser currently. So I just click on the button and you can see that was executed order for the first client, for the second, for the third one, and this is the data which arrived from the server. And inside the network tab you can see this three HTTP calls has been executed. So let's get back and replace our switch map with concatMap. Here we go. And as you already know, concatMap puts all, let's say, orders into the queue. So they will be executed one by one. So once the first stream make the room completes, will be scheduled the second one. Then when second one completes, will be scheduled the third one, and so on and so forth. So let's see it in the action. And in order to better illustrate everything to you, I would suggest to increase the throttling for our network, and such a way you can emulate very slow network. So you can switch to slow 3G. And now if I click very fast all these three buttons, you will see that they will be executed one by one in the order they actually emitted. So we can click 1, 3, and 2, and you can see one by one they were executed exactly in the order these orders has been arrived. So 1, 3, 2, not 1, 2, 3, but 1, 3, 2, because I clicked 1, 3, 2. So this is the basically idea behind the concat map. So but what will happen if we replace it with ExhaustMap? And as you remember from the mental model, ExhaustMap will be ignoring all subsequent orders until this inner stream is active. Yeah. So if we save it and go back to our application, and if I click right now client one order, and then very fast I will click client 2 and client 3, those two will be ignored. Yeah, so let's check this out. I click first one, second one, third one. You can see only first one executed, and those two were ignored because I triggered those two orders at the time when the order for the first client was being executed. So it was busy, that's why it has ignored those two orders. Okay, so now once we executed the first order, so HTTP call is being done, this first order has been completed, and now ExhaustMap is ready to take the another order. And now if I click very fast 2, 3, and 1, only second order will be executed, and first and third one will be ignored. So let's check this out. I click 2, 3, 1, and you can see only the second has been executed. And now if I click 3, 2, will be executed only 3. Yeah, because third order arrived when ExhaustMap had no any active stream, and the second one was ignored because the third one was active. Okay, I hope you understood kind of the difference between them. And the last thing I would like to highlight is that don't forget that ExhaustMap as well as concatMap, they both wait until this stream, this inner stream, is completed. Not when they emit some value, but when they complete it. you should understand that here currently, when we do HTTP call, we have a deal with finite stream, which automatically completes once we receive some data from the server or encounter some error. Yeah. But if you have here infinite stream, if you created, for example, from user clicks and you don't have any condition when this stream should be completed, then the subsequent order will never be reached, because here the stream is kind of infinite and it will never complete. So concatMap will not proceed with the second order, third order, and so on. This is what you have to keep in mind. All right, guys, that was it. I hope you enjoyed this video and it was useful. Please don't forget about your feedback, leave your comments, share this video if you like it, and of course, check out my video courses about Angular material theming and GraphQL engine called Hasura. Links and discounts will be in the video descriptions. I wish you a productive week, stay safe, and see you in the next video.